aid to those who need it most. The roaring waters that bring disaster to fertile valleys have a terrible rival in the drought which has afflicted thousands of square miles of our western plains. Ruin and famine come in the wake of the hot, dry winds which tear the rich soil from the grass roots. Here again, the shock troops of disaster marshal their forces against devastation. Dust, once the valuable topsoil of the farm country, is now carried in whirling clouds, choking and blinding people and livestock, rolling on higher, wider and blacker until the land itself, upon which everything else depends, the land it took nature 100 years to the inch to build up, is blowing away. In this emergency, too, the shock troops of disaster marshal their forces against devastation. With the aid of WPA workers, food, housing, and medical care are provided for those who have been driven from their homesteads by the threat of famine. There is great immediate danger from inflammation of eyes, throats, and lungs tortured by dust. Expert clinical care for children and adults is provided to minimize the danger to life and health. In addition to their vital work of providing the necessities of life for refugees, the WPA has found work for thousands of farmers who have been deprived of a livelihood by the drought. These men are working on projects important to the afflicted area, such as roads and fire lanes. To them, this work provides a means of carrying on in the face of the hardships inflicted by nature. Drought is a grave national problem, correcting it a mammoth undertaking. As a step in this direction, relief workers are engaged in the construction of many dams to conserve future rainfalls. Construction work on water conservation projects requires an immense number of skilled and unskilled workers, providing immediate employment for hundreds of those who would otherwise be on relief. Those who suffered because of the drought are now employed on projects designed for their own future benefit. Thus, the works program answers the need of both the individual and the community. Comes the added peril of fire, an ever-present danger to lives and property.